It dawned on me as I reflected upon the scripture that God led me to for today that there would be something particularly powerful and effective if that scripture was spoken through the voice of one of our younger generation. For it is a scripture about new life and hope. And the younger generation represents to us that new life and hope for all of us. So I am so glad to welcome to this pulpit today Parker Richardson, who's going to come and read our scripture.
Bibles to Isaiah 65, chapters 17 through 25. For see, I'm creating new heavens and a new earth, so wonderful that no one will even think about the old ones anymore. Be glad, rejoice forever in my creation. Look, I will recreate Jerusalem as a place of happiness, and her people shall be a joy. And I will rejoice in Jerusalem and in my people, and the voice of weeping and crying shall not be heard there anymore. No longer will babies die when only a few days old. No longer will men be considered old at 100. Only sinners will die young. In those days, when a man builds a house, he will keep on living in it. It will not be destroyed by invading armies as in the past. My people will plant gardens and eat the fruit themselves. Their enemies will not take it. For my people will live as long as trees and will long enjoy their hard-won gains. Their harvest will not be eaten by their enemies. Their children will not be born to be cannon fodder. For they are the children of those the Lord has blessed, and their children too shall be blessed. I will answer them before they even call to me. While they are still talking to me about their needs, I will go ahead and answer their prayers. The wolf and the lamb shall feed together. The lion shall eat straw as the ox does, and poisonous snakes shall strike no more. In these days, nothing and no one shall be hurt or destroyed in my holy mountain, said the Lord. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.